So guys, remember when I said that I already stopped hauling a lot of makeup? That's still true, okay? Today, I have a Sephora order here. The box looks huge, but that's because I ordered for two people. Because I was actually supposed to go to Texas back in May until the end of May. From the 17th of May, and I was supposed to come back to here in Australia on, I think it was the 3rd of June. But for some complex reason regarding my visa and my ability to travel, I was not able to go, and I kind of wasted a return flight from Sydney to Houston. But let's not even go there because I'm just like pissed off. Anyway, I was supposed to go to Texas, so I did an order online during the Sephora spring VIB sale for some things that I needed to replenish on. And because I knew that I was going to the States, I told my friend who is a makeup geek like myself that if she wanted me to order for her, I would do that, and then I'll just bring it back with me when I come home. Yeah, I had to pay for shipping to get this here because now I'm not going to Texas. I might still go, but not anytime in the near future. Anyway, so that's why that box is big. But really, I only ordered a few things, and most of them, if not all of them, are simple replenishments of what I wanted to get. And I wanted to show you guys because, yeah, why not, right? In this huge Sephora box, I have two of my The Ordinary Glycolic Acid 7% solution. And I got this because I couldn't find this here in Australia. Priceline and Meijer carry The Ordinary, but they never have the glycolic acid solution. So I went ahead and bought this at the Sephora VIB sale. And then about, I guess 2 weeks ago, I went to the Rocks Market here in Sydney and passed by a shop that called itself the Abnormal Skincare, I think it's what it's called. I'm gonna write it down below. But they carry The Ordinary and a lot of other products from DSCM, I think that's what it's called. And they have it there for $14.50. I don't remember how much this is in US dollars, but that I bought one of these here in Sydney for $14.50 Australian dollars. So that I think translates to something like maybe $11 or $12 US. So anyway, because I ran out of mine. I've been without it for more than a month now. So I thought I'd order two so that it'll last longer, even though now I have one. So now I have a total of three. Anyway, I digress. And then I have run out of my IT Cosmetics CC cream. So I thought, what better way or better time for me to try the new CC oil-free matte with SPF 40. So this is the one, and I got it in the color medium tan because medium in the normal CC cream is too light for me and tan is too dark for me. So I actually end up having to buy two, which is also wasteful. So yeah, I got this one in the in-between shade of medium tan. My only gripe with this is that the normal CC cream, the original one, has got SPF 50, whereas this one only has 40. Not that that's a big difference, and it's not like I stay in the sun all the time, but I just like my high SPF. But we'll see how this goes. I'll let you know if I actually enjoy this, because the original CC cream, I find that it kind of breaks down on me at towards the end of the day because I've got oily skin, as you can probably tell. I don't have any foundation today. I only have SPF, my Neutrogena SPF, so that's what it is. And this came, I actually bought this with a value pack, this one here, which is their CC Plus kit. And inside comes the Confidence in a Cleanser, the Secret Sauce, which is a clinically advanced miraculous eye anti-aging moisturizer, whatever. and the It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Eye Cream. So that's what's in here, and hopefully they are in here. It doesn't look like they are. Oh yeah, there's little bits inside here. I'm not gonna open it up because I'm not gonna use this yet, so that's all good. And then the only other thing that I bought that I've never bought before is from Pat McGrath, and I wanted to try her lipstick. She came out with this mini matte trance, and this is in the version Skin Show Trio. Inside is the shades Omi, 1995, and Flesh 3. You see what I mean with excessive packaging? Like, why do we need all those sequences? Right? And why do I need this foil plastic packaging? Can it not be in a packaging that's a little bit more environmentally friendly, Pat McGrath? Like, look, sure, it looks cute, but I don't need those sequences. So, yeah. Anyway, these are the nude shades, and I wanted to try them, but I wanted to buy something that I knew I was going to wear. So I did that. Actually, I'm a liar. There's one last thing. This is the Bite Beauty Outburst Long Wear Lip Stain in Sangria Slush, which is their sort of like red shade. And I was wanting to try this because I was looking for a beautiful red for my lips. And because it's autumn here in Australia, it's fine for me to do that. Oh, and look at how red that red is. I am excited to try that out. Because my other red is quite matte from MAC, and it's kind of drying. And then they gave me a freebie, which is this little Kiehl's Powerful Strength Line Reducing Concentrate with 12.5% vitamin C and hyaluronic acid. Can you tell I'm looking after my skin because I'm starting to age? Anyway, that is it. That is what's inside this big box. The other stuff are for my friend, which I'm going to take to work tomorrow so that she can have it. I do hope you enjoyed this little haul of mine, which are essentially essentials, okay? And if you ever see hauls like this here, it's probably going to be the same, like a couple of things that I just really needed to restock on. All right. Thank you for watching. Let me know in the comment section down below what you want to see next. I am putting together a jeans collection, and I'll let you know which ones were thrifted or secondhand and which ones were bought new. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Bye.